in the Tahoe Basin especially, we have bears that like to hibernate in crawl spaces and under decks. So I thought we'd put together a little video for you to show you how to secure that. So got a pretend crawl space entrance right here. Of course, crawl spaces are all sorts of shapes and sizes. Don't be fooled by the size of your crawl space door. Bears can get in very small places. So as part of your winterization of your home, secure your crawl space. It's very simple. All you need is a piece of plywood, and we recommend 3/4-inch plywood. It needs to be tough and thick because bears have those little cat claws and they can tear wood apart. That's part of what they do out in the wild. The other thing that you need is a lag screw or a lag bolt. We recommend these because if you use just a typical nail, a bear can pull that out of the siding very easily. So you need a really hefty duty screw to be able to secure it and not have the bear be able to pull it out. And attach a fender washer to the back end of that screw, so when you put it in, you've got that much more surface area that's gonna make it hard for the bear to pop that out. We'll show you how it's done. So you'll take your plywood board and you're gonna put it flush over your crawl space, okay? You want that flat surface. If you have a little bit of a lip there, the bear can grab onto it and pull that off. You're gonna drill in your hole. Okay, once you've got your pilot hole drilled, go ahead and you just put your lag bolt in. And it's that easy. You want to do repeated ones across. Again, you want to secure this as much as you possibly can so the bear can't find any weakness. So we'll do that on all four sides. Secure crawl space. If I can do it, you can do it. It's definitely a contractor can do it. Ideally, somebody else would do it prettier than this, but we have flush edges so the bears can't get their claws in. We've got our lag screws and our 3/4-inch plywood. Very important to remember that. There you go, bear's not getting in and your crawl space is secure. We want to encourage the bear to go and make a den as a normal bear would, but since we have the opportunity, why don't we go take a look at what a den looks like? So as you can see, it's a pretty elaborate nest that the bear has made in here. It's pulled in all the pine needles it can find. There's even a little bit of insulation from around the pipes. Very, very cozy, sheltered. If this was under a house, this would probably have a lot of insulation in it as they pull it down from up above. They can also snap some wires and pull down electrical lines. They also leave a hole open to your crawl space where really cold air can get in there and cause your water pipes to freeze. Bears, once they've invested in making this kind of a den, are going to come back. So it's very important to secure it and discourage the bear from returning. In order to do that in this situation, we went ahead and put up an electric fencing structure around the porch to just help deter the bear from coming back here. The electric is a safe way to just tell the bear you need to go and find yourself a home somewhere else, ideally underneath a rock or in a tree. We hope these suggestions have been helpful for you. We want to make sure that our homeowners up in the Tahoe Basin are able to keep their homes secure, but we also want to do this for our bears. We desperately want our Tahoe bears to be wild and to remain wild. And when our bears start making urban dens, it exposes them to habituation and food conditioning that we want to try and avoid. So don't do it just for yourself, do it for our bears too. Help us keep our bears wild.